Delical cats meet once a year on the night we make the Jellicle choice. And now that the Jellicle leader is here, Jellicle cats can all rejoice! Of the awful battle of the Pekes and the Pollicles, together with some account of the participation of the Pugs and the Palms, and the intervention of the great Rumpus Cat. The Pekes and the Pollicles, everyone knows, are proud and implacable, passionate foes. It is always the same wherever one goes. And the Pugs and the Pums, although most people say that they do not like fighting, yet once in a way they now and again join into the fray. And they until you can hear them all over the park. Now, on the occasion of which I shall speak, almost nothing had happened for nearly a week, and that's a long time for a paw or a peek. The big police dog was away from his beat. I don't know the reason, but most people think he slipped into the Wellington Arms for a drink. And no one at all was about on the street when a peek and a pollicle happened to meet. They did not advance or exactly retreat, but they glared at each other and scraped their hind feet and started to
bark, 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 bark,
until you could hear them all over the park. And they
bark, 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 bark,
until you could hear them all over the park. Now the Peek, although people may say what they please, is no British dog, but a heathen Chinese. And so all the Peeks, when they heard the uproar, some came to the window, some came to the door. There were surely a dozen, more likely a score, and together they started to grumble and wheeze in their huffery, snuffery, heathen Chinese. But a terrible din is what Pollicles like, for your Pollicle dog is a door yorkshire tyke. And to those that are frisky and frolical, let my meaning be perfectly plain. And his broad Scottish cousins are snappers and biters, and every dog jack of them knowed were fighters. And so they step out with their papers in order, playing when the blue bonnets come over the border. Then the Pugs and the Palms held no longer aloof, but some from the balcony, some from the roof, joined into the din with a until you could hear them all over the park. Until you could hear them all over the park. These bold heroes together assembled. The traffic all stopped, and the underground trembled. And some of the neighbors were so much afraid that they started to ring up the fire brigade. When suddenly up from a small basement flat, why, who should stalk out but the great Rumpus Cat! Eyes were like fireballs, fearfully blazing. He gave a great yawn, and his jaws were amazing. And when he looked out through the bars of the area, you never saw anything fiercer. terrier. And what with the glare of his eyes and his yawning, the peaks and the pollicles quickly took warning. He looked to the sky and he gave a great leap, and they, every last one of them, scattered like sheep. And when the police dog returned to his beat, there wasn't a single one left on the street.